Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
So, Anvita, you have had quite an unusual journey, right? From advertising to screenwriting, being a lyrics writer, and now writing and directing a feature film.
So, I've always enjoyed being a rookie because I came into the film industry, I was 35. So, I was a newcomer and learning new things at the age of 35. So, it was awesome. This is about 13 years ago. Again, it was accidental, it was good fortune, whatever you might call it. And the same with becoming a director. I wrote Bulbul for myself, just for joy. Just wanted the story, it just came from somewhere. I'm blessed. But the moment I put it down, the moment I finished writing the script, there was that certain amount of greed and certain amount of love. But, you know, that possessive love for the story that I decided that I'm not going to give it to any director. I'm not going to pitch it to any director. I'm going to direct it. So that's how it happened that I decided to become a director because I wrote Bulbul. So she's responsible for that as well.
Did it cross your mind that if you had not done direction, whether this task is going to be daunting for you?
I don't think I was daunted by it. I was excited by it. This is going to be fun. I'm going to do this. And fortunately for me, I got producers who had the same amount of faith in me. So they also never questioned the fact that I was a first-time director or doubted. They just judged me on my material. And like one of my friends said that, you've directed it on the page. So it's there on paper. It's already there in the script, what it's going to look like, what it's going to feel like, what is the shot taking of it. So I think somewhere all those things, I drew my confidence from that. And then I got such incredible people to come on board. These are people who will get my vision and will be able to execute it with me. So I don't think I was daunted. I was just excited.
What made you choose that period, that setting, the Bengal Zamindar setting?
It's a fantastical tale. It's like a fairy tale, right? So it could have been set anywhere. Like I tell people that, even if Bulbul was set underwater, it would still be the same story. So even if it was on another planet, it would still be the same story. But Bengal of that period, the neoclassical period, aesthetically and, it just appeals to me a lot. So instead of setting it in another world or another planet, I decided to set it in Bengal, and just the beauty, the art, the architecture, everything added to that fairy tale like quality of the film, the fable like quality of the film. So, and of course, another influence was when I read Tagore and his women. The way he wrote his women was so sensitively written. Their helplessness, their fragility and their strength. And I think somewhere subconsciously even that influenced me, that I would like to tell this tale in Bengal of the period that he was setting his stories in.
Was it in some way hat tip to Charulata? Because probably if Charulata with supernatural element been like this, who knows?
You know, you're the first person who's picked that up. Nashtunir, so yes, not Charulata, Nashtunir. Yeah. I'd read Nashtunir, I think about 15 years ago. And oh my God, I was so deeply moved by that story. And I think it must have obviously been there because there are shades of Nashtunir in film. So yes. There is Tagore there somewhere.
You're very economical with your expression in the movie. Be it the dialogue, be it the setting, even the number of people you have used. Did it come to you naturally?
One is yes, it was written like that. But possibly it was written like that for a couple of reasons. One is that I'm an introvert. So I silence, though I'm a dialogue writer and a lyricist, I've started off like that, which is all about conversation and words, and I do love words, but I I think there is so much in silence. So many things can be said in silences. So many things can be, you know, in the song, my favorite parts are the you know, what we call the music one, the music two, which is the musical interludes that come in the middle, because I feel those are the things that actually transition you from one mood to the other, that kind of stuff. So I like silences. I like intimacy. I like the thought of, the house being the world. Mm-hmm. So just that one house with just those many people actually symbolizing the world.
So where did you find that beautiful house in which the most of the story unfolds?
It's actually 2.5 hours out of Kolkata. It is this place called Bhavali. So it's actually a Rajbari from that period, okay. From the neoclassical period. I was so fortunate. We actually, when we went on our recce, we saw such beautiful properties in Bengal, all over Bengal. We drove around everywhere looking for Bulbul's house. And when I saw this place, I was like, this is exactly how I imagined, because it's true to the period. It's really beautiful and impressive. But what I really like about the house is the fact that it's like a box. It's huge, but there are these high walls. You don't see any escape. You don't see exit. The only door in the house is a very small, shadowy door. So you cannot exit from anywhere in the house other than that door. And that to me was, I was like, this is such a beautiful prison. And that's why I wanted to use it.
Of course, your movie is a very strong statement against patriarchy. Is that a statement you wanted to send out?
The first thing that comes to you is the story. The storyteller is just putting down a story, spinning a yarn, you know, calling you close and saying, okay, you know, once upon a time. And you just want to do that. You want to engage with your audience or the person who's sitting in front of you to, you just say, pata hai kya hua? You know, so you want to just do that. But what happens is the things that move you as a human being, forget about as a woman or anything like that, as a human being, will come into your story. So when you are of a certain age, when you've lived life for a number of years, the way that I have, and you've lived in this world, and there are things that have bothered you, affected you, moved you, and the things that you noticed, you know, it gets inside your skin. So when you're writing, it comes on paper. So you don't set out to say, pick up the pencil and paper and say, today let me write a story about patriarchy. It always starts with, today let me tell you a story. Mm-hmm. But because the things that affect you might be patriarchy or misogyny, mm-hmm. or the fact that women take so much time to come into their own. Because of the way they've been brought up, because of the way they've been told that that's the way they are supposed to be. Those are the things that affect me personally. So it will come in my storytelling. I will consciously, subconsciously, whatever, I will bring it into my storytelling. My characters will address the issues that bother me.